Indicators of a large left to right shunt are cardiac enlargement, presence of flow murmurs, third heart sound, and a white pulse pressure in case of patent ductus arteriosus. Left to right intracardiac or extracardiac shunts typically increase the pulmonary blood flow. In a large left to right shunt, the QP by QS, that is the ratio of pulmonary to systemic blood flow, is more than 2:1. Features of large shunt depend on the level of the shunt and also whether it is pre or post tricuspid. Please subscribe to this channel for future updates. Click on the subscribe button. Press the bell icon after that for all updates. Pre-tricuspid shunts occur at the level of the great veins and at the atrial level. Post-tricuspid shunts are either at the ventricular level or at the great artery level. Pre-tricuspid left-right shunts are either due to an anomalous drainage of pulmonary veins to the right side of the heart or an atrial septal defect. The flow into the right atrium, right ventricle and pulmonary artery are increased, leading to dilatation of all these chambers. Pre-tricuspid shunts seldom produce heart failure as the LV is not affected. Tricuspid diastolic flow murmur and an RV third heart sound are audible in case of large shunts. Pulmonary ejection systolic murmur due to enhanced flow is universal and in fact more easily audible than the tricuspid flow murmur. RA enlargement may be recognizable clinically by the rightward enlargement of the right cardiac border. Here is an X-ray chest PA view in AST which had large left-right shunt showing enlargement of right atrium, main and right pulmonary arteries. Left pulmonary artery shadow is behind the cardiac solute. Branch pulmonary vessels are enlarged and end-on views are seen. Right ventricular type of upturned apex is visible. Peripheral pruning of pulmonary vessels indicate severe pulmonary hypertension. The classical post-tricuspid shunts are ventricular septal defects and patent ductus arteriosus. The other post-tricuspid shunts, truncus arteriosus and aortic pulmonary window, are less likely to manifest a large left-right shunt due to the early development of severe pulmonary hypertension, which reduces the magnitude of left-right shunt in spite of a large defect. Post-tricuspid shunts cause left ventricular overload and failure in infancy. Flow murmur in the mitral area and left ventricular third heart sound are heard in post-tricuspid left-right shunts. A finding unique to a large PDA is a wide pulse pressure due to aortic runoff. X-ray chest PA view in a VST with the left-right shunt and hyperdynamic pulmonary hypertension. There is cardiomegaly, prominent main pulmonary artery segment and right pulmonary artery. Enlarged left pulmonary artery shadow is seen below the left cardiac border within the cardiac solute. The enhanced vascular markings are visible on the right side whereas it is obscured by the cardiac shadow on the left side. Katz-Wachtel phenomenon bar sign is tall diaphasic RS complexes at least 50 mm in height in leads V2, V3 or V4, that is the mid-precordial leads. The sign has been described in VST with large left-right shunt and biventricular hypertrophy in children. Please don't forget to subscribe to this channel for future updates and click on the bell icon for all updates. Thank you.